take up the second basic chemistry practicals. In this session, I am showing to you stoichiometric analysis. Our experiment M is determination of molarity of potassium permanganate using 0.1 molar ferrous ammonium sulfate by volumetric analysis. Coming to principle, acid-fed potassium permanganate can oxidize ferrous sulfate or ferrous ammonium sulfate into ferric sulfate. Hence, known volume of the ferrous ammonium sulfate is titrated against potassium permanganate. Coming to reaction, here ferrous ion is converting into ferric ion. Its loss of electrons are taking place, so this reaction is called as the oxidation. And permanganate ion is converting into the Mn2+. Here gaining of electrons are taking place, so this reaction is called as the reduction reaction. So both oxidation and reduction reactions are taking place, so this titration we also call as a redox titration. Next procedure. Exactly 10 ml of 1.1 molar ferrous ammonium sulfate is prepared into a clean conical flask and about 1 test tube full of dilute H2SO4 is added. Next one. The solution of conical flask is titrated against potassium permanganate taken in the burette until a permanent pale pink color is obtained. This is the end point of the titration. And the burette readings are recorded and repeated the titration by agreeing values. Next, I will show you the demonstration of this titration. During the titration, here first we will be taking the potassium permanganate in the burette. This is called as the burette stand. Before using the burette, first we have to wash with the rinse with the distilled water. The burette with potassium permanganate solution. When we are rinsing with the potassium permanganate solution, here whatever the moisture will be there in the burette, it will drain off. Now I am filling the burette by using the funnel with potassium permanganate solution. I am filling above the zero mark and I am removing the funnel from the burette, and at the nozzle whatever the air gap is there, we have to fill that by opening the this gap. Here we can fill it, and we have to adjust to the zero by taking upper viscous of the solution, because for the color solutions we have to take the upper viscous. Here the initial burette I had filled till zero, and I am fixing the burette to the burette stand, and here I have taken that the burette stand which is containing the white, and if we are not having the white means we can give the white type. Here what is the use of the white here means whatever the color changes will take place in this reaction we can make out clearly. Next, I am taking the 10 ml of the pipette. I am rinsing with water first to remove the dust particles. And I am rinsing with the ferrous ammonium sulfate. Because whatever the moisture will be there, it will drain off inside the pipette. After rinsing with potassium permanganate solution,
Here you can make out the calibration mark on the pipette. Above the calibration mark, we have to pipette out the ferrous ammonium sulfate, that is 10 ml. And after pipetting out, we have to close the end of the pipette with our index finger. Here this one we have to transfer into a washed conical flask. And while transferring the ferrous ammonium sulphate into the conical flask, the pipette, it has to touch the bottom of the conical flask. The entire solution, it will go into the conical flask. After transferring of the 10 ml of the ferrous ammonium sulphate, we have to take the one full test tube of the sulfuric acid. Then we have to transfer into a conical flask. After transferring the one full test tube of the dilute sulfuric acid, we have to titrate the ferrous ammonium sulfate against the potassium permanganate. Here we have to leave the potassium permanganate solution into the conical flask drop by drop. While titrating the ferrous ammonium sulfate, we have to rotate or the mix the solution. It ensures that uniform mixing of the potassium permanganate solution inside the conical flask it will take place. We have to titrate until to get the permanent pale pink color. Uniform mixing of the solution has to be taken, otherwise the complete reaction it won't take place. It will be giving that precision values. You won't get the accurate value. We have to titrate the ferrous ammonium sulfate by adding potassium permanganate solution and we have to mix it thoroughly throughout the titration until it turns pale pink. Here, I got the permanent pale pink color. If you are shaking, if it is disappearing, that is not permanent color. If after shaking also, if color retains, that is called as the permanent pale pink color. After this, we have to take out the burette and we have to note down the burette reading. While taking the burette reading, we have to take the upper miscus of the solution because this is the colored solution. Here you can see the burette reading, that is 9.4 ml. So here whatever the endpoint burette reading we had taken, that is called as it's an endpoint, that we will be taking as the final reading. What we had filled at the beginning, that is the initial reading. What we had got here, 9.6, that is the final burette reading. And we have to repeat this titration until concordant values are obtained. So after obtaining these values, we have to tabulate these values in the tabulation column. Okay. When we perform the titration, we had seen these observations. Always we have taken the which solution concentration we have to find out, that solution we have to take into the burette, and known concentration solution we have to pipette out into the conical flask.
particle flux. Here our known concentration solution, that is the ferrous ammonium sulfate, that is 10 ml of the 0.1 molar ferrous ammonium sulfate we had taken, and we had added the one full test tube of the dilute sulfuric acid also. And here, because of this colored solution of the potassium permanganate, it acts as the self indicator. And here we got the colorless solution, it turned to the permanent pale pink color. And here what the values we had taken is, here we had first I had filled the burette with the potassium permanganate solution and I adjusted to the zero. So that we will be taking as the initial burette reading. And what we got the final value at the end point, that we will be taking as the final burette reading. And here, yes, we will be repeating this titration until to get the concurrent values are obtained. So here, I am getting the same values. Once you get the concurrent two concurrent values, there is no need of doing the titration third time. Here, this I am stopping the for the two trials only. And here, volume of potassium permanganate in ml is nothing but whatever the final burette reading you get, that will be considered as the volume of potassium permanganate consumed by the ferrous ammonium sulfate. That is 9.4, and here also 9.4. Whatever the volume of potassium permanganate we got here, that will be considered as the volume of potassium permanganate as V1. Volume of potassium permanganate V1 we will be taking, that is 9.4 ml. Next, coming to the calculation, A1 M1 V1 of potassium permanganate and A2 M2 V2 of ferrous ammonium sulfate. And here A1 is nothing but gain of electrons. In redox reactions, one potassium permanganate, one mole of potassium permanganate, it will be gaining the 5 electrons. That is, M1 is nothing but the molar rate of the potassium permanganate what we have to find out. V1 is nothing but that is the volume of potassium permanganate what is consumed in the reaction. That is 9.4 ml. Coming to the A2. A2 loss of electrons by ferrous ammonium sulfate is the one. M2 is the molar rate of the ferrous ammonium sulfate what we have taken, 0.1 molar. And V2 is volume of ferrous ammonium sulfate we had prepared out the 10 ml. That is, we had taken the 10 ml. Next, V1 M1. So if you send the A1 V1 inside here, we will get the formula as A2 M2 V2 divided by A1 V1. Now substituting the all these values in the formula, A2 is 1, M2 is 0.1 and V2 is 10 ml. Next, A1 is 5 and V1 is how much volume we got, KmNO4 consumed in the titration, that is 9.4 ml. Now, here we will get that 1 into 0.1 into 10 is the 1. The KmNO4 consumed is 0.021. Here the strength of the or the concentration of the potassium permanganate is 0.021 molar solution. This is that our strength of the potassium permanganate what we titrated again is the 0.1 molar of ferrous ammonium sulfate solution. Thank you.